Around the house, she only comes in the kitchen. Went anywhere else, I think there might be a marital dispute. So no, she just comes in the kitchen. But Bela as a character is the nosy neighbour. She's the neck curtain twitcher. If she was someone next door to you, she'd be watching what was going on, who was going where, checking it all out, and making sure she knew what was what. So she's quite a character as our Bela. Oh, Bela's now 5. I've had her since she was 2. She can be up to, but no more than 42 inches measured from her wither, at the base of her neck, just down to the ground. She was actually born on the island of Yell in the Shetland Islands. And at the age of 2, she then came down to live with me. Bela first came into the house. I was turning her out in the field and I needed something from the kitchen. So I thought about taking her back to the stables, but couldn't be bothered. And then I thought, well, I'll tie her up outside. And then I just thought, she'll just walk in with me. And she did. So it's been ongoing since then, really. She just really comes in on high days and holidays. And if the grandchildren are around, you know, just for a bit of a fun, a giggle. She only comes in for short cups of tea, particularly. Well, I'm sure other Shetlands have been other people's houses, but it's just a bit of fun, really. You know, not very long period of time, just a bit of a giggle and a fun coming into the house. Well, catering for Bela, I tend to move the best crockery off the table, definitely. And when she's got her nose in the fridge, not that that happens very often, but you have to be careful, otherwise she'd be ferreting through the whole thing. You know, she's a standard Shetland. She's a Labrador of the horse world. She'd eat anything she'd get her hands on. So you have to just be a bit sensible.